For this video, we're going to be working with the flange you see here on the screen. We're going to create another mating flange to that and then grab some bolts and nuts from the internet, download those, and then insert them into this model. And then we can use those to pattern them around to bolt these two flanges together. Now, of course, you could design your own bolts and nuts, but why do all that extra work when they're freely available from the internet? All right, to get started, let's create the secondary flange. So right over here, you can see I've got this part. And you could, create a whole nother flange from the beginning, but why do that when you have the mirror command available to us? So let's go ahead, spin this around, and that's the bottom of the part there, and I wanna create a little gap, right? Because I don't want these to be flange to flange. You could, of course, if you just came down here and said, hey, I just want to use that flange here. I wanna create a transform or a mirror. Here's my mirror. I could say, hey, I'd like to select this entire body, which would be right here. I could then say I'd like to use like this flange right here and then mirrored across. The problem if you do all that though is these are touching, right? There's no gap, right? If you zoom in here, you can see there's no gap between the two. And generally you want to have a gasket between these flanges. So we need to create some construction geometry and create a plane, right? So right over here, you can see here, I've got this thing called add and I say construction plane. I can choose that one right there. I can choose that. And click on next, and then I want to do the offset. So I want to drag that plane down a little bit. And most of those flanges, or sorry, not flange, but the gaskets are about 50,000. So I actually want to do about half that. So 0.025 is half of 50,000. And click OK, and now I've got that plane there. So I'm going to use that plane to mirror this thing over. So right over here, here's the body. And come down here to more, click on mirror, and I'm going to choose that plane to create that mirror. Now, if we zoom in here, we can see we've got a little gap that we could then, of course, put, there's the gap that we can put a gasket in if you need to or want to. But in this case, I want to focus on the bolts and the nuts. Okay, now, of course, we could design our own bolts and nuts, but, you know, it's a lot easier to download those things off the internet. So let me show you a source that I use, depending on where you happen to be in the world. In this case here, I'm using McMaster-Carr. In the US, McMaster-Carr is a hardware store that has just about everything you can ever imagine, and they also allow you to download those things in step files, or a whole bunch of other different types of files right here, but step happens to work probably the best for importing to Shaper. So go over ahead and choose this, hit download, same thing with the nut, go over here, choose step, hit download, but I've already done that, so let's just go ahead and use the files I've already downloaded. So back over here, I want to come over here to file. I want to say import to current project. Okay, so first one, I want to go ahead and grab that bolt, click on open, and that should import that bolt right into the center of this model. Here it is. And if you click on this little twirl down here, there is the shape. I'm going to grab this one here. I'm going to rotate that around so that says 90, or just type in 90 on your screen. And then, of course, I want to drag that out over to here. It happens to be 5.875, happens to be right in the center of that hole, and that looks pretty good. I'm gonna spin this thing around a little bit so I can look closer at it, and I wanna bring that down. So it's just pretty much right at the surface of the model there. That looks great to me. There's my bolt. Very easy, way less work than actually creating the bolt yourself, and now we have it right in the model. Let's do it one more time here. I'm gonna go File, Import to Current Project. This one, as you can imagine, we're gonna go ahead and grab the nut. Click OK, or click open, it's gonna import that file, and here it is again. And if I choose that twirl down, click on that one there, I can move it down just a little bit, and then drag it out so it's at that, let's see where we're at, 5.875, and then spin that around. And let's go ahead and zoom in here a little bit so we can see what's going on. And we're gonna move that up into position right about there. Okay, so now we've got the bolt, we have the nut. Now we could of course keep importing these things in, but that would be obviously not a lot of extra work. Why do that when we can just pattern this thing around? So we've got a couple handy tools available to us over here. And here's our transform, and we have pattern, right? So here's our pattern. But before we do that, I want to turn on a couple other sketches here. So we can make sure, let's turn that off. So right over here is a sketch of where this whole thing was these holes originally created from. We're gonna use that to find that center point. Then come over here to transform, and we're gonna use the pattern. Of course, we're gonna be doing a circular pattern. And what do we wanna pattern around? Well, I'd like to pattern the bolt itself, which I think is right here, and the nut, which is down there. So I can select both of those. Let's see what happens. So there's both of those. All right, and then we want to pattern those. So I'm going to spin this thing so it's over here and grab that middle, that point, and I'm going to snap that right to the center of that pattern. All right, so we have that there. And then I'm going to grab this little arrow here, and I'm going to start dragging this thing around. And notice you can see those little bolts spinning around there. And the angle is 360, right? And the total is going to be 8, right? And there you go. So we've got 8. And click OK. Spin that around. And now you can see we've got those different the bolts and the nuts. Here's the spacing. Everything's looking pretty solid here. Of course, you can turn some of these sketches off or on as needed. And then when you got it done, you're pretty much looking solid like this. You've got the two flanges, you've got the plane that we put between the two, and now you've got the bolts. If you need to make any modifications, of course, you can go over here to the history bar, and you can see how we've created this part from the very beginning. Starting over here, we mirrored that over, we imported that bolt, we moved it over to position, imported the nut, moved it to position, and then of course we patterned them around. And if you ever needed to change how many parts you're patterning, or if you added something else in, of course you could add more over here. You can choose the center point, you can move things, you can change the angle, and so on. You can do all those adjustments right over here in the history bar. And of course, by using the patterning tools and the mirroring tools, we've saved ourselves a whole bunch of time. And of course, the availability of parts that are on the internet is just getting more and more every day. So definitely, if you have a standard part, like a nut, a bolt, a cylinder, anything you're going to purchase, generally those files are available to you. You can download them as a step file, an IGES file, or any other format, and then import them as Shaper. It's going to save you a whole bunch of time in the long run. Thanks for watching.